Frontotemporal dementia is a less common form of dementia and is most likely to occur in people aged between 45 and 65. Dementia that occurs before the age of 65 is referred to as younger onset dementia. Frontotemporal dementia was previously called Pick's disease. It is now best understood as a spectrum disorder. It causes progressive damage to the front and temporal lobes of the brain, affecting a person's mood, behaviour, and language. It occurs when there is an accumulation of abnormal proteins in brain cells, causing these cells to die. Studies have identified three types of protein: tau, TDP43, and more recently, FUS, or fused in sarcoma protein. The cause of this accumulation of protein is unknown. There can sometimes be a strong family link, but most often this is not the case. Whilst about 20 to 30% of people with a diagnosis have a family history of dementia, only 10 to 15% of those will have a genetic mutation as the cause. There are three major subtypes of frontotemporal dementia. Each person will experience different initial symptoms depending on the part of the brain involved and the progression of the disorder. Behavioural variant frontotemporal dementia is the most common form and is characterised by changes in behaviour and personality. There may be difficulties in retrieving memories and a loss of emotional response.
Going back about 3 years, Michael lost his brother, and he was going through a rough time, which to me, not being a medical person, but I identified a bit of depression.
I had been seeing my own doctor anyway, and we had talked about depression, we had talked about a number of other things at the time, how it was affecting me in my work life, how it was influencing what I was doing, and now I'm bringing it up to him, so, look, it's affecting home too.
Part of Michael's diagnosis is the behaviour variant. So I feel like I now have tools or are able to dismiss some of the behavioural changes that I come across day to day.
People with semantic dementia have language and knowledge difficulties, such as finding the right words. Progressive non-fluent aphasia is the least common form of frontotemporal dementia. In many cases, a person may not be able to produce words or speak fluently.
They notice changes in CAM at work. Customers also noticed changes. The bosses noticed that he wasn't singing. Cam's always happy-go-lucky and pretty crazy, and noticed that he wasn't singing, and just little things like that. It's hard. It's hard to see somebody that you love and chose to spend your life with kind of changing.
And it's going to change for the rest of the life.
That's right. Not being the same person that he was that I met 18 years ago. He is, but he isn't.
At the moment, it's fantastic because there's a lot of volunteers and friends and everyone's trying to help me. I'm not sure if it's because I'm 41 and what I've got. It's stupid what I've got, but hey. You just have to live with it. So.
Frontotemporal dementia is more common in younger people. There can be a family history, but in most cases there is not. It may impact on personality, emotions and behaviour, language and knowledge, word production and fluency.